In my previous video, many of you have commented that you guys are facing some error when you are trying to set up graphics shortage in CodeBlocks 20.03, which is currently the latest version of CodeBlocks. So I decided to create this separate video on this issue. Hey guys, my name is Ramesh and you are watching CodeWar. So in this video, I'll explain how to set up graphics shortage in CodeBlocks 20.03, and this will work on any new version of CodeBlocks which will come later. So let's begin. Okay, so here I'm assuming that you have installed CodeBlocks 20.03 along with the compiler provided with it, and you have already tried to set up graphics shortage using my previous video, but you are facing this error. By the way, if you are new to my channel and this is the first time you are trying to set up graphics shortage in CodeBlocks, then you can skip this part. Now let me explain first, why are you facing this error message? Fatal error, graphics shortage, no such file or directory. Actually, in our case, the problem is related to compiler compatibility. Let me explain this with a short example. Okay, before running this program, I will have to remove the flags from other linker options. So, if you run this program, you will get an output like this. Here you can notice this line, target x86_64. If you are also getting a similar output, then it means you have a 64-bit compiler. And this is actually creating the problem. The graphics library that we have is compatible with 32-bit compiler. But here we have 64-bit compiler, right? So when we are trying to compile our program, the compiler is trying to generate 64-bit output. And as we have 32-bit version of graphics library, the compiler is simply ignoring graphics.h headerfile, and that is why we are getting this error. So to solve this problem, we can do one thing. First, we will set up 32-bit compiler in CodeBlocks, and then we will set up graphics.h in it. So let's start. So first of all, you will have to download this 32-bit compiler from this website. I have mentioned the link in the description of this video. So visit this site and download this 32-bit compiler. So after downloading, we will have to install it. So double click on this file to start installation. Now uncheck this check for updates option and click on create. Click on next and install. This will take some time, so just wait for it to complete. Okay, so our compiler is installed successfully. Click on next and finish. Now we have to copy graphics library in our compiler. You can download it from my Google Drive. I have mentioned the link in the description of this video. Okay, after downloading, you will get a zip file like this. Now extract this zip file. Now select graphics.h and winbgm.h. Copy it. Now you have to go to include folder of the compiler. So go to this location. C drive, TDM, GCC32, include. Now paste it here. In the folder where you extracted the zip file, there is a file with name libbgi.a. Copy it and paste it to the lib folder of your compiler. You can see this location inside C drive, TDM, GCC32, There is a leaf folder. You have to paste it here. So we are done with files. Now we have to configure our 32-bit compiler with code blocks and add the appropriate linker options. Now open code blocks. In the menu bar, go to Settings, Compiler. Go to this Toolchain Executables. Now here you have to select the directory of our new 32-bit compiler. So click on this Browse button. Now go to C drive and select this TDM-GCC32 folder. Now click on Select folder. Now go to Linker Settings. And in the other linker options, write these flags -lbgi space -lgdi32 space -lcomdlg32 space -luuid space -lolEAUT32 space -lole32. Now click on OK. So we have set graphics storage in code blocks. Now let's create a new project and check whether it is working properly or not. Create a new project. Select console application and click on Go. Click Next. Now, as I have already explained in my previous video, if you want to write graphics program, then always select C++ as your language. So select C++ and click on Next. Enter your project title. Now browse to select a location where you want your project to be created. I am selecting desktop here. Click on Next and Finish. Now let's write a short program using graphics storage. Okay, so the program is complete. Now click on this build and run button or simply press the F9 key. You can see it is working properly. So guys, that's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.